और अब सीधे रुख करते हैं दिल्ली के विज्ञान भवन का, जहां पर जीएसटी परिषद की बैठक के बाद वित्त मंत्री अरुण जेटली मीडिया को संबोधित कर रहे हैं।
फिर कुछ नए लोग भी इसमें आएंगे, जो रेट्स हमने तय किए हैं। रजिस्ट्रेशन हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन फेयरली सेटिस्फैक्टरीली इन द आईटी सिस्टम एंड एज ऑफ टुडे 65.6 लाख, that is 81.1%, have already taken their provisional registration. The GST and executives are here, they can explain to you the technicalities in detail. A number of companies and trades have been raising the issue of the lack of their own preparedness. Now, we don't have the luxury of time to defer the implementation of the GST. Everybody, we have been saying in advance that be ready, it will be implemented from 1st of July. And therefore, the council decided categorically that it will be implemented from the 1st of July onwards. In order to, and the registrations will go on, they are, I think, again reopening on the 25th of June. And we hope that the new people who will come within the fold will rapidly register themselves. In any case, the registration process has been going on quite satisfactorily. When thousands and lakhs register, they don't make a complaint. When five people have a grievance, they go through the Twitter. That's been the experience. 81% have registered without any glitches. The preparedness will come in when they have to file their return. The return for the month of July will have to be filed ordinarily by the 10th of August. So we are today on 18th. So even today there are 42 days to get ready before the return is filed. In any case, to obviate any grievance or any lack of preparedness, a slight relaxation of time for the first 2 months, that is return for the month of July and August, was discussed, and from September the strict adherence to the time will go on. Dr. Adia will give you the somewhat relaxation which has been given, which actually means that those who are not ready after relaxation will have more than two and a half months to get ready. And if somebody still says he's not ready, then it is to his own detriment. Dr. Adi, after I conclude, will just give you the change dates. The official launch of the GST will take place on the midnight of 30th and 1st. At a function which will be organized in Delhi. We will be soon giving you all the details of that program. To you. This is all I had to say. Dr. Adi will
explain. जो शिपिंग वाली बात है वो ऐसा था कि वी हैव पुट 5% आईजीएसटी ऑन एनी शिप विच इज इम्पोर्टेड. नाउ द शिपर्स दैट सेइंग कि इफ यू आर बाइंग अ शिप देन देयर आउटपुट टैक्स लायबिलिटी ऑन द सर्विस टैक्स इज ओनली 5% एंड दैट ऑल्सो बिकॉज द शिप्स विच आर ओन्ड बाय इंडियन शिप फ्लैग ओनर्स दे आर ऑल्सो फ्लाइंग समवेयर एल्स इन द वर्ल्ड सो दे आर ऑल मूविंग अराउंड इन द वर्ल्ड दे डोंट हैव एनी आउटपुट टैक्स लायबिलिटी हियर. So how do we recover this? So we are actually giving them the facility. पहले हमने ये कहा था कि यू कैन ओनली रिकवर you can only take input tax credit in respect of services out of the service tax liability. Output tax liability on account of services, they can take input tax credit only for services. Now what we have said is ki even the ship, whatever 5% IGST paid on the ship, they can take input tax credit for the same when they are plying the ship in India and when they have the output tax liability in India. So there is a facility that we are giving. The second issue is about the migration. About this return filing. Actually, we are supposed to strictly accept the return based on the invoice-wise detail in case of all B2C, B2B supplies. So the GSTR 1 has to be filed by 10th of every month. GSTR 2, which is purchase detail, will be auto-populated by computer, which is to be done by 15th of the next month, which computer will do. You have to simply accept it. And GSTR 3 will automatically be generated by computer based on GSTR 1 and 2. That is also auto-populated. So virtually there is only one return, GSTR 1. But there also, what we are saying is that for the first 2 months, instead of insisting on exact invoice-to-invoice data immediately, they will be filing a simple form in form number 3B. There is a new form, which is a small form, it is a slight modification of 3. 3 would be generated by computer, but 3B will be filed by SSE himself. So form number 3B will be filed for the month of July by 20th of August. And for the month of August, it will be filed by 20th of September. This form will be self-declaration in the form of saying that this is my output tax liability, this is my input tax credit according to my own accounts, and this is my total tax liability. And then he will declare his tax liability, pay that much of money so that the government does not lose income every month, because we need income every month, so we have to ensure that we get our income. Having said that, what we are saying is that we are not saying that they will not at all enter invoice-wise detail in GSTR 1 for the month of July and August. They will enter invoice-wise detail for July and August also, but we are giving a slightly relaxed time for that. So for the month of July, the invoice-wise detail can be, our system will open for filing invoice-wise detail from 15th of July. And during that period, all the systems can be tested by all the GSPs also, by ERPs of various companies. They can have 15 days more to test that system. So from 15th of July, our system will open. And for the month of July, they can continue putting their invoice-wise detail, and they will have time up to 5th of September. But before 5th of September, all SSEs will have to give their invoice-wise detail in GSTR 1. And those who are having B2C business, they will have to give their turnover detail in GSTR 1 by 5th of September.
So time is September.
About, yeah, that is the time they get. Then for the month of August also, of course, as I told you, form number 3B will be filed separately. It is a summary form, and he will pay tax accordingly. But August, for the month of August, the data of GSTR 1 will have to be filed by 20th of September. So they'll get 10 more days there also. Normally they would have done it by 10th of September. They'll get 10 days more for the month of August also. So that is what they can do in the month of September. So based on both this GSTR 1, which is filed in the month of for July and August, GSTR 2 will be automatically generated, and GSTR 3 will also be automatically generated for them, for which separate dates are being given. So that is the timetable that we have now. So virtually they are getting some more time for preparing their systems, etc. And the first 2 months return will be based on their own assessment of taxation, which they will do. Subsequently, return number 3, which is generated by the computer, will be compared with return 3B, which is self-filed by them. And if there is any difference in tax amount, it will be payable by the tax SSE. Okay? So that is the system that we have adopted for the first 2 months. Regarding the migration, I would like to request all the members of the public that they should not rush, because as it is, there is no difference between provisional ID number and the new GST number. the same provision, isn't it? Provisional ID number will be the same final number. It is only that they need a certificate from us that all the details have been received. But they exactly get 3 months time to do it. So even if suppose they have not done it, they don't need to really create a panic about it. They can take 30 days at least, you know. So when it opens on 25th, not everybody needs to immediately migrate. As long as they have got a provisional ID, they'll be able to continue their business and they'll be able to sort of file their return. So that is not a problem. For the new registrants, because there are a lot of businesses which are now being taxed, which were earlier not in tax. So those businesses have to register now. For them also, there is a period of 30 days available. So although the new registration will start from 25th, they need not rush again. And they need not say that by 1st of July, I have to get the registration number. They can get 30 days to get a registration number from GST. So that also one should keep in mind. Naveen Kumar or Prakash, would you like to add something?
You have covered most of the things.
Okay. So, any questions?
Sir, इसमें ईवे बिल की जो व्यवस्था भी लागू की गई है, कब तक हम लोग उम्मीद करें कि ईवे बिल की व्यवस्था लागू?
देखिए, एक बार जुलाई 1st को लागू हो जाए, क्योंकि अधिकतर स्टेट राज्यों का कहना था कि उन्होंने ईवे की अपनी एक व्यवस्था बनाई हुई है और उनको लगता था कि उनकी चेकिंग से जो ईवे बिल की करते हैं, बहुमत में वो राज्य थे तो उससे काफी इवेजन को चेक करने में सहायता मिलती है. कुछ राज्यों का कहना था कि अगर जीएसटी सिस्टम इस्टेब्लिश हो जाता है तो इसकी शायद आवश्यकता कम हो जाए. तीसरा एक मत यह था कि शहर के भीतर इंट्रा सिटी इसकी आवश्यकता नहीं है, इंटर स्टेट में या लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल में इसकी आवश्यकता है, क्योंकि इस पे विभिन्न मत थे लोगों के, तो इस पे और चर्चा की अभी जरूरत है. और काउंसिल में क्योंकि हम कंसेंसस से निर्णय लेते हैं, वो संभव नहीं था. तो मुझे लगता है कि एक बार लागू होने के बाद हम लोग मिलेंगे. अगली मीटिंग जो है हमारी वो 30 तारीख को विज्ञान भवन में होगी, एक दिन पहले. उसी दिन लॉन्च होना रात को, तो लोगों को हम उस लॉन्च के लिए भी आमंत्रित कर रहे हैं. तो उस दिन या उससे अगली मीटिंग में कभी ना कभी तय करेंगे.
सर, छोटे व्यापारी पार्टी है कि जो नॉन कंप्लायंस होता है, उसके लिए कम से कम 6 महीने का वक्त दिया जाए, उसको कोई पेनल कार्रवाई ना की जाए, इसके बारे में सोचेंगे?
देखिए, ट्रांजिशन फेज में रिलैक्सेशन का प्रावधान है हमारे पास, लेकिन हम ये चाहेंगे कि जितनी जल्दी इसका इम्प्लीमेंट हो सके वो हो. और हमने जो आज सहूलियत दी है कि अगस्त वाली के लिए आपके पास 2.5 महीने हैं, सितंबर वाली के लिए और 15 दिन एक्स्ट्रा हैं, ये इसीलिए दिया है कि लोगों का पहले 2 महीने में अभ्यास बन जाए और सिस्टम के ऊपर भी एकाएक ओवरलोडिंग ना हो.
सर 15 तारीख को सीबीसी ने एक सर्कुलर जारी किया था रियल एस्टेट को लेकर, खासतौर से आगाह करते हुए. उसके बावजूद हम देख रहे हैं कि एनसीआर में कई बायर्स के पास रिटर्न पहुंचने के 30 जून से पहले जो है बकाया अमाउंट जमा करा दे, अन्यथा उनको 12% जो है सर्विस टैक्स देना होगा. इसको लेकर कुछ गंभीरता, क्योंकि कई जगह रेगुलेटेड नहीं है सर.
वो गलत है,
वो गलत है, इसलिए हमने क्लैरिटी दिया था प्रेस नोट के माध्यम से. और प्रेस नोट के आने से भी काफी जागरूकता आई है ग्राहकों में. बट फिर भी हमने हुपा, हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन पॉवर्टी सेक्रेटरी को भी लिखा है चिट्ठी, और मैंने उनको रिक्वेस्ट किया है कि ये बात हर स्टेट को पहुंचाए, हर स्टेट के रेरा के जो रेगुलेटर है उनको भी बताए, और उनके जो एसोसिएशन है उनके साथ हुपा के सेक्रेटरी को हमने रिक्वेस्ट किया है कि वो मीटिंग करे, उनको समझाए.
टेक्निकली ये जो इनपुट क्रेडिट मिलेगा रियल इस्टेट पे 1 जुलाई के बाद और टैक्सेशन में से वो घटेगा, और उसमें जो कटौती आती है उसमें प्राइस रिडक्शन होना चाहिए. ये नहीं कि उसकी कटौती का सारा लाभ डेवलपर को जाए. दैट प्राइस रिडक्शन हैज टू बी पास्ड